Hi students and welcome back to Bank Exams today. And the SBI PO prelims came with a surprise for the students. If we talk about the English section, like the students were preparing for error detection, error supporting. So what happened that they came across the questions based on phrase replacement that they were not prepared for. Like there is nothing different between the error spotting and phrase replacement, but the basic difference is that in error spotting you have to find the error only, but while we are doing the phrase replacement you have to find the error first and then replace the phrase or the part of the sentence which contains an error from the given options. So students were quite surprised when they saw that kind of question in the exam. So to solve your problems and to let you know more about the phrase replacement, I have come with some ideas and some basics of phrase replacement that you will get to know in this video tutorial. The first thing you have to keep in mind that there is nothing different between error spotting and error phrase replacement. You have to know about the tenses and the syntax of the sentence, or more about you should know how the sentence is made, because the phrase replacement is basically based on the tenses, grammatical errors and conjunctions, helping verbs. These kind of errors are there in the phrase replacement that you have to find out and then replace with the given options. So first let us know on what basis the phrase replacement questions can be based. The first one is phrases. As the name suggests, the phrase replacement means there are some phrases that you should know. In English grammar or English language, there are abundant of phrases that you must know, like come in. These are phrases, and with the verb or with the word that comes with another word or two or three words, it becomes a phrase. And when this word changes, the meaning of the phrasal verb or phrasal words change accordingly. So you must try to memorize some kind of phrases and their meanings first. Then the second is tense. Sometimes a sentence contains an error based on the tenses, and similarly in the phrase replacement as well. And the third is narration, which is quite common in phrase replacement questions. Then fourth one is helping verbs. Fifth is conjunctions. Sixth is sentence structure. Like you have some sentence whose structure is not clear, so you have to shuffle the words in the options so to make the sentence grammatically correct. And then the seventh is models. Clear? So in this video we are going to start from the basics of phrase replacement, and in the next video I am going to share with you some high level questions of phrase replacement that you can learn and practice. Clear? Before starting, I would like you to go to the YouTube, subscribe to our channel Bank Exams Today, and there is a video on tenses, because some of the students are not aware of all the rules of sentences and tenses. So you must learn all kinds of rules of grammar and basically the tenses. So I have made a video and that is on YouTube. Go to our channel Bank Exams Today and there is a video with the title Tenses in Hindi and English. So you can go and check that video. First, the sentence says less than a million of rupees are required immediately. Go to the bank and withdraw immediately. First, the underlined phrase or part of the sentence is rupees are, And the options we have rupees were, rupees was, rupees to be and rupees is. Try to analyze the tense of the sentence. Less than a million of rupees are required immediately. Go to the bank and withdraw the money. Right? So, there is no problem in the tense of the sentence. Because we have go to the bank and withdraw the money, it is a kind of order or request. So, the problem lies where? First, rupees were. We do not want to change the tense of the sentence. Rupees was. Again, there is a change of tense. Rupees to be. Here, it is like a kind of possibility. Which will completely change the meaning of the sentence. So, these three options are eliminated. And we are left with rupees is. First, this is the way to solve this question. And the second is words like less, much, little, always take singular verb. If you have read the subject verb agreement in the video or you have learned these earlier, so you must memorize that less, much, little kind of adjectives take singular verb. Clear? I can give you an example of this. A little of good habits makes life easy. Now here, because the sentence is starting with a little, and that's why we are using singular verb. Clear? Now, the second sentence is soap and salad are a wholesome food. And the error is in are a. Options are not, may be a, is a. If you are talking about soap and salad, then there is not to, we do not think twice that the soup and salad are wholesome food, right? But where is the error then? Maybe a, do you doubt that soap and salad are good food? No, right? So, we already have a R here, so we do not need a R. R not because the facts cannot be changed, so it is eliminated. Maybe we do not doubt that salad and soups are bad for health, then this is eliminated. Then we are left with only is a. So here we will have to place is a. Reason being that when two nouns are used as a common idea, then the verb it takes is always singular. Clear? Like bread and butter is my favorite. Rice and curry is delicious. So, if two words are representing a common thing or common idea, then we take singular verb. Clear? Now we will move to our next sentences. Now the third sentence that we have is, I as well as my mother are going to attend the meeting. And the options we have are, am going, is going, were going and had been going. So here the rule which is applied, that when you are having as well as in the sentence, then the helping verb should be according to the first noun or pronoun. If you had we here, we are well, as well as our mother, then it will be correct to use are here. But as we are having I as a first noun in the sentence, after that we are using as well as my mother, then we must have a singular helping verb here, which is only used in am, because we cannot use is for I, were for I and had been, because had been is a kind of change in the type of tense that we do not do in short sentences. If you are having long sentences, then you must analyze if do you need to change the tense of the sentence according to the other parts. But here the sentence is quite short and you do not require to change the tense of the sentence. That's why we have to choose between these three, and we have I, so only am is the helping verb that we use with the I. So our correct answer is am going. Clear? Then the fourth sentence says, a mango is considered the king of fruits. There is nothing wrong, I guess, in the sentence, but yes, there is a mistake that we should know. First is an apple, an mango, the mango, or the D option can be. No corrections required. First, an apple cannot be the placed here, because we do not want to change anything except the grammatical errors. We do not want to change the nouns and pronouns in the sentence. Then we have an mango, which is evident that cannot be used, because an is a vowel that we use with, an is an article that we use only with vowels. Clear? And so we are left with only the mango. Why the mango? Because mango is representing a class, a group. So whenever we are using a word which is representing the class, a complete class or group of people or group of things, then we use mango, then we use the article. But there is an exceptional case, because in the case of men and women, because both the words represent a class, so we do not need to use the with them. It is only for the non-living things. Now, the fifth sentence says, he bought 10 dozens of bananas. And the error is in this part of the sentence. So, did bought 10 dozens, had bought 10 dozens, bought 10 dozen, no correction. First, did and bought, incorrect, because we can't use two similar form of verbs in a sentence. Then, had bought 10 dozens. Do we need to change the tense of the sentence? No. Then, we have no correction and bought 10 dozens. Words like dozen, kilo, are like a pair of shoes, million, thousand, always used in singular form. We do not have plural form of these words like millions, thousand, dozen. Okay? So the correct answer is C. Then the option 6 says, I have been working for you since 4 months. 4 months, 4 month, which is evidently incorrect. Then less than 4 months, because the person is trying to say that he has been working with someone for 4 months. Then this is incorrect to change the time period, and the DV option says no correction. But there is a mistake, because you must know the difference between since and for. Since is used with the words or time period, which is quite accurate, and for is used when we are representing the approximation of time, like 4 months, 3 months, when the time is not clear to you or which is not fixed. But if the time is fixed, then you can use since, like since Monday, since morning. So here we will use for 4 months. I have been working for you for 4 months. So if you are having short sentences in your paper, then you must read a sentence twice. Sometimes the sentences are so easy that while we speak or read them, we get to know about the errors. But if the sentence is quite long or lengthy, then you must analyze the tenses and sentences structures. Clear? I'm giving you some examples of since and for. Like if we were talking about the time approximation, my mother had been ill for Monday. Here we are not representing the approximation of time. We have a particular definite time period, and which is Monday. That's why we are using since here, right? And the next example I would like you to use, that I want one of the book kept on the table, right? If you are having the words like one of, two of, three of, then after the noun used after of should be plural. Like he has taken many of the books, one of the books, three of the books, and four of the books. And similarly, it is, this rule applies on any of. You can take any of the book, any of the books. So I think I have made myself very clear in the basics of phrase replacement. I want you to go to the previous videos that we have uploaded on our YouTube channel and on the courses, video courses, in which we have taught you how to spot the errors and tenses and some subject verb agreement rules to be applied while we are using error detection. And till then, you have to keep practicing the short form or short sentences. In the next video, we are going to use some very tough sentences for phrase replacement. Till then, keep practicing, and all the best. Thank you.